Good morning. You guys were hot today. It was great. So good. Are the table set before you? Everything, all things. Happy Thanksgiving. I've got to tell you how thankful I am to be here. I know I say this when I come back all the time, but I trust that you have some inkling or understanding of the great, joyous spiritual community that you're part of. It is just, I come here and I'm sitting over there in the corner in my usual seat, crying my eyes out for this whole day. Really, I mean, tears just rolling down my cheeks when things happen or when I see people. And it was like I've only away for 3 weeks, so, you know. But that's the depth and the incredible power that we get to have when we are conscious of something of great value in our life. Conscious of something of great value. I've discovered in my experience, and Dr. Deborah covered a lot of the points when she was giving her preamble. You would have thought that she slept with me last night, and I spoke in my sleep because she picked up all the little ideas I was going to use, which was really good. But I got to tell you is that we teach that what we focus on and where we put our intention, that where we put our mind becomes the form and the experience of our life. And it's not that we teach it because it's a good thing to know. We teach it because it's the law. It really happens. It really works that way. And every person here, in one way or another, whether you believe it or not, utilize that thing that we call the law of mind in your lives. And that the experience that we have in our life is the experience that we created, that we planted, that we implanted, that we nurtured, that we supported, and that inevitably became the form of the experience. And I know that that's tough sometimes when there's something going on in your life, in an experience in the present moment, in the current reality, where it really doesn't feel like that should be real. There might be something that occurred or something that happened that feels like it's totally out of sync with who you are and what you believe and what you think. And yet somehow or other, our thoughts create that form. And we have to avoid the idea to think that it is only our conscious thinking that creates it. It is the unconscious thinking as well. It is the habits that we pick up. It is the routines that we have. It's all of the different ways and means that we get to gather in the information. It comes from our society. It comes from the way we were raised. It comes from our genetics. It comes from our thoughts. It comes from everything combined to come together to create the experience. And the reason I'm saying this is because just as easily as we created that experience, we can recreate and create something new in the other side. Life has seasons. And we plant something, we nurture it and support it, and it ends up in a time to harvest. And the present moment right now is the moment of the harvest that you were involved in. Your experience is the harvest of that which you planted sometime in the past and that which you have nurtured and supported. And you know, the incredible thing is that no matter how you know that or how steeped in it that you might be, no matter how conscious I am around it, I still find myself planting seeds that I have no desire whatsoever to harvest or to reap. And I still find myself in that situation when I do that, of planting those seeds and then having that thought come into my mind that says, do you really want to have the effect of that idea in your life? And inevitably, this little voice comes up inside me and justifies why I should plant it in the first place. Without consideration for the causation that I am creating, for that which is going to come forward in my experience, without any idea whatsoever for that, I simply still go ahead and plant it. I still work on it. I'll give you an example. This is Thanksgiving, and no matter how you look at it, or no matter what you look at, no matter what's happening in your circumstance, no matter what's happening in your life, no matter what's happening in my circumstance or my life, there is more to be grateful for in the world than there is not to be. And yet somehow or other, I fall into this habit in my own experience of finding things that I get to create, that I get to carry on and have contentiousness around. Perhaps you know what I'm talking about. that even though I'm consciously aware that it creates a form, I still turn around and I still find myself bemoaning it. I was going to use a different word, but complaining about it. You know, yesterday, as a matter of fact, I had our in-laws came over to visit us, our son's in-laws, beautiful people. And Deborah said to me, the wind had been blowing, it had been blustery, and we live in a pine forest. And so the pine needles in our yard are about ankle deep everywhere you walk. And so Deb said, in a very polite way, oh, I'd be so embarrassed if they come over and all those pine needles are out there. Which is like saying, get out and clean the pine needles. Just, that's the polite metaphysical way to do it. And I wasn't upset that she said it. I said, great. So I went out and I started to do it. And here I am raking up all these pine needles, cleaning up pine needles. And you know what? Even though my mind was set on creating a Thanksgiving talk, and my mind was working through the process of, you know, in everything be grateful. Because the truth is that if I just spent my life being grateful for what's in my life, then I would be planting the seed to create more things to be grateful in my experience, right? And yet, I find myself even knowing that, even being conscious of that, even working on putting together a talk to tell you about that, I find myself bemoaning, I was going to use a different word, bemoaning these pine needles out in my yard. And complaining about them. The abundance is everywhere. My God, those pine needles, if they were dollars, I'd be rich. But that's where my mind was going as I tried to stumble my way out of finding myself complaining. Do you understand what I'm saying? And it's just pine needles. And there are so many things I could be grateful for. I'm grateful for the trees. I'm grateful to have a home. I'm grateful to live in the forest. I was grateful that the sun was shining. I was grateful that it wasn't too hot and it wasn't too cold. I was grateful that I had to move my vehicles in order to be able to clean the pine needles underneath them. I was grateful to have the vehicles. I was grateful to have the tools to be able to do it. I was grateful to be able to have the health that allowed me to be able to do that, to have the mobility and the strength to allow me to do that. I was grateful that I had the time to be able to perform it. All of those things are sitting there waiting for me to put my focus on, to plant the seed, to develop something more to be grateful for. And instead, what I'm doing is I'm spending this time carping and complaining and bemoaning, and I was going to use a different word, about that. It was just incredible that even though I'm aware of what the outpicturing could be, I still find myself in that situation. Now, obviously, I began to twist my mind around, but those habits of complaining and bemoaning, they go really, really deep. Have you noticed that? You know, I sit there and I smile and I say, okay, I'm going to change my mind about this. And I do it for about 2 more minutes and then I fall asleep again in my conscious awareness. And the next thing you know, I'm cursing it again. I'm giving it heck again. I'm complaining about it again. And yet, there's all these things to be grateful for that are waiting for me on the other side. It's about habits. Our lives are about the habits that we have created. And most of us, and I'm not going to talk for all of you, because I'm sure there's someone out there who lives in absolute gratitude 24 hours a day. I haven't met you yet, but I'm sure you're here. And yet, that is the nature that we fall into that. It's not that I'm creating it intentionally, but it's still creating an experience for me to be able to have. I tell you, I travel a fair amount, and I always hate to come up and give travelogues, but the thing is that I've spent a fair amount of my life in airplanes and traveling these days, and a fair amount in hotels. And As I pointed out to some of you, the romance out of this goes away pretty quick. It disappears, you know, when you're spending all your time in a hotel room or in a hotel lobby or whatever that goes with it. And there's lots of things that I get to go out there and I can recount things to be grateful for, and yet there I am. And so tomorrow morning at 6, as Dr. Deborah pointed out, we get to get up and we get to fly to Rome. And then we get to spend a couple days in Paris on our way home from there. Do you know that I can actually find it within my heart to complain about that? Seriously. I know you'll go. But that's the mentality that we live in sometimes. Have you noticed that? It's not just me, is it? God, hope it's not just me. Because if it is, then you guys should be up here and I should be back there. But you know, that's that key, is somehow or other within me, there is that ability, the minute I lay my guard down, the minute that I stop using gratitude as the focus point of my life, the minute that I put it down and I stop being conscious of it, something pops up and comes into my experience that gives me the opportunity to bemoan. I could have used a different word. So, is that your experience? Yes. Okay, I'm glad. Then I'm talking to the right audience. So the question is, what do we do about that? And, you know, I think that the tool that we really need to know is we need to be so consciously aware of it that we could choose, if we wanted to begin to change that attitude, to be able to change that habit form that we've gotten into that puts us into a place where what we're doing is we're complaining and bemoaning something no matter how good it is or how great it is. So here's what I plan on doing. I plan on, because I was aware of that and because I was working on this talk and because it suddenly dawned on me that a lot of my experiences in my life are created from my carping and my complaining, it suddenly occurred to me that what I need to do is I need to start doing an exercise on a daily basis about gratitude. I need to choose to find something in my life to be grateful for at least once a day, if not more. I need to take the time and the discipline to sit down and to actually look at the world around me and start developing gratitude in me. Now, I know Dr. Deborah, for example, has a gratitude journal she fills in every night. And I've done that exercise. But what I want to do is I want to change the exercise of how I view everything in my life at the time. I would like to bring it in and be more present with it. I don't just want to talk about the things that I'm grateful for that are obvious that I should be grateful for. What I want to do is I want to get into the depth of it. What I want to do is I want to be able to promote and provoke an idea within myself that goes to a place of gratitude before it goes to a place of bemoaning. What I want to do is I want to awaken a spirit within me that puts my intention habitually on the area of gratitude. I want to become the most Pollyanna, grateful person you've ever met in your life. Yes. It's about time, right? So in order to do that, what I think I will do is I am going to start in my daily habit, I am going to start practicing bringing forward the experiences that I had throughout the day and find the ones where I was complaining, where I was fearful, where I darked it out, find the ones that I've fallen asleep on, and bring them forward. An example being, if I thought today about what I did yesterday, it would come forward that I was actually carping about pine needles in the midst of the abundance of my life. To give you another idea, complaining about the fact that my truck is dirty instead of being grateful that it's clean. Give you another idea, complaining about Deborah telling me what to do all the time instead of being grateful for Deborah to be there. Give you another idea. Being grateful for the people in my life who might not be in my life this time next year. Like my sister, to be able to look at it and stop looking at it from a complaint point of view instead of look at it from a joyful, joyous point of view, being grateful for the time I get to spend with her. Being grateful for the time that I get to spend with you as opposed to the time that I'm traveling. Being grateful and being aware and cognizant and conscious of my spiritual community, being aware and conscious of my children and my grandchildren, even when they're being snarly, being able to put myself into mind and into life where what I do is I begin to rise, not stop complaining, but start being grateful and make the difference and make the change. And there is no better time to do it than today, which is Thanksgiving Day. And there's no better time to practice. I don't know what anyone's doing for Thanksgiving dinner, but I will tell you this, there's something great to be thankful for. There's something wonderful to be in the presence of the people. There's something tremendous to be able to share with that. And it's my intention, no matter what happens, no matter what occurs, no matter how it looks, to find that place and live from that gratitude. Now, I would recommend, or I would choose, or I would challenge, or I would tell you that that's what I want you to do. Not just today, but I want you to do it every day. I want you to live from a place of gratitude. If there's only one prayer you ever say, and it is a prayer of thanksgiving, it is enough. I want you to start living from gratitude every second of every day. Now, I know to do that, what we need to do is we need to change where we're sitting and what we're set up with right now. And it's not somebody, I'm not blaming anybody, I'm just simply saying it is the history and the nature of our culture to go to that place of dissatisfaction and contention. And I have created every contentious moment I've ever had in my life without a question. When I look back on it, and if I had a health challenge, or if I had a wealth challenge, or if I had a loving challenge, or if I had a challenge about fulfillment or productivity, every single time and every single place, I was the one that created it. And I created it by allowing my mind to become contentious and focused on where I thought the pain was, where I thought the contention was, where I thought the resentment was. And allowed myself to be able to grow and develop and build it. And the end result is in my life today, right now, right here, I get to harvest those results. And so do you if you're doing it. So my challenge in life is to understand that this cycle that's going on around us that we call life, what happens in nature happens within us in the same way. To begin to plant seeds of gratitude in everything that I do, no matter what they look like or what the circumstances are. Would you like to do that? Would you like to pray on this? Would you like me to do a treatment? Okay. Let's center ourselves. And allow ourselves to be in that place of grace. Allowing life to flow no matter what. And let's bring our conscious ideas forward to allow this to drift into our being and into our lives, no matter what it looks like, whether we call it good, bad, or indifferent. We simply let it be and we let it flow. For I believe in God and absolutely nothing else. And I recognize and know that I'm unified with it and that it operates through me and through you and through all things, through the consciousness and direction of that thought and that idea that I implant. I know that it creates form no matter what. And I know that that form becomes the experience that I have in my life in every area and every facet. Accepting and being aware of this, I speak my word for each of us, knowing and understanding that from this moment forward, we are clearly aware that our thoughts are creating the form of our experience. I therefore know that with that awareness, we are conscious every time we begin to plant the seeds of ideas that create the form that we do not want to express and experience. I speak my word knowing and understanding that the higher power within each of us has come forward with a conscious awareness right here and right now. And that that awareness will no longer ever allow us to go into that mode of complaining as a habit. Instead, when we see it and recognize and experience it, we simply discard it and dissolve it and allow it to flow behind us and turn instead with our ideas and our mind to an idea that we have something to be grateful for. And we find that thing within our own mind, our own idea, and our own being, and we live from that. We live from it now, we live from it forever. For we, at this moment, are changed at depth. There is never a time in any of our experiences that we can ever come forward with that idea of bemoaning a situation or an idea without first recognizing and accepting that there is a goodness that is given unto us through it as it, for the table is laid before us. And we choose with consideration and care that which we place into our mind. And from this moment forward, we in this center plant an idea that is greater than any idea that we've had before. And that idea is that life is joyous, that life is good, and that there is nothing but that which we look forward to being grateful for. We discard and dissolve all anxiety and all false expectations, and we embrace the ideal that is the truth of our being today and every day. I know that this is set right here and right now, and that no one person needs to do any other thing. For this moment forward, that higher power brings into enlightenment and brings forward that awareness and that alertness to this idea. And that each of us is imbued with the courage and the power and the understanding and the intelligence to change and move and focus not on the dark, but yes, on the light. I expect this to be so. And with an unconditional gratitude that it's already complete and already done, I surrender it back to that universal mind, which is your mind, my mind, and all mind. And I demand that it be my truth. I accept it and I live from it. And I ground this by saying, and so it is. Thank you. God bless you.